We humans have been making maps for millennia. Wayfinding, where do we leave our stuff, strategy, all kinds of things. Maps are a part of us. They just make sense to us. We've been doing it forever. What do people really know about mapping, which is the beating heart of GIS? Let's take it to the streets and ask some fellow map nerds some trivia. Can you tell me the name of the person who's considered the father of GIS?
Well, I can have a great guess. I think it's Jack, but I don't know.
Because Jack is the stepfather of GIS. That's okay. True, yeah. Who is considered to be the father of GIS?
Roger Tomlinson. I'm reading his book.
You're reading his book?
Yeah. I'm studying for my GIS too.
No, high five and a handshake. The 60s were a wild time, I've been told. We put a man on the moon, Star Trek, Elvis. Computers are getting amazing. Things are going bananas. What a time to be alive. And what a time for GIS to get its kick. Roger Tomlinson up in Canada was doing some amazing things with maps inside a computer. A few short years later, something interesting was going on at a lab in Harvard. What was going on there? It was the seeds of GIS being planted. A little thing called Esri was founded. Do you know what year Esri was founded?
I'm gonna guess 1984.
Oh, almost. Esri's a little bit older than that.
Okay.
It was founded in 1969. Close. By Jack and Laura Danger. Yeah. I don't know if you knew that.
I did know that.
Okay, he knew that. Fast forward a few years and we're into the 80s and 90s. Amazing things are happening. We've got mullets all over the place. MTV, ET, ArcInfo is released in 1982. I wonder if you can take a swing at what year the first Esri user conference happened.
I can tell you this is my first year, but for the first one, I'm going to guess maybe 1973, 4, 8, 9, 81.
81. Oh, you got it.
There we go.
1981. I'm here with a first-time Esri UC attendee, and I have a question for her. Excuse me, miss. What year was the first Esri user conference? That's right, 1981. And then in 1991, something amazing happens. GIS goes mainstream. Everybody's talking about it. By the end of the decade, GIS had its very own day. GIS Day. Lindsay, I have a question for you. Just, can you tell me what year the first GIS Day happened?
We're gonna go with 1987.
Ooh, actually, it's a little bit later.
89.
Oh, almost, just literally one decade off.
1999.
You nailed it! What year did the first GIS Day happen?
82.
Ooh, you know what? It should have happened in 1982.
It should have happened in 82.
I'm going to go with it should have happened in 1982. You get partial credit. In fact, the first official GIS Day happened in 1999.
See, that's what I was pretty close.
You were practically there.
I was
essentially right.
Yes. 99. That's what I thought. I was thinking 99.
Yeah, always go with your gut. Everybody's rooting for somebody on Survivor. We've got the International Space Station whizzing overhead. Everybody took those giant computers, crunched them down into little rectangles that we hold in our phone. We're looking at data on our phones, we're broadcasting data from our phones, all kinds of amazing things are going on. Technology is more accessible than ever, which means GIS is more accessible than ever. In the year 2001, how many GIS users were there in the world?
In the world. Well, considering the software came in the 90s, late 90s, I would say roughly less than 10,000.
Oh my goodness. Well, guess what? GIS has got a surprise for you because it was actually 1 million.
1 million.
Because in the United States, the percentage of universities that offer GIS courses is what? Take a stab.
78%.
No, it's way more than that. And the answer shocked me too. It's 95% of universities in the United States offer GIS courses.
There we go.
Nowadays, GIS is everywhere. People are making kajillions of maps every day, and they're doing it to illuminate challenges and provide solutions. You're doing it. It's this shared love of GIS that's helping us unite our world. And I want to thank you for being a part of our big Mappy family.